Today we're going to learn about Fibonacci heaps. A Fibonacci heap is a data structure that implements a mergeable heap. A mergeable heap supports the following five operations: make heap, insert, minimum, extract min, and union, which as you can guess is where the name mergeable heap comes from. Let's break down each of these methods. Make heap creates an empty heap. Insert inserts a node into the heap. Minimum returns the minimum node. Extract min deletes the minimum node and returns it. And union merges two heaps. We've previously covered binary heaps on this channel, but Fibonacci heaps are beneficial in specific situations. This is because certain operations run in constant amortized time. Amortized is similar to average, but it's the average time over a sequence of operations. In other words, it's the average performance of each operation in the worst case. Fibonacci heaps support two other operations: decrease key, which decreases the key for a node with the value that is less than or equal to the current value, and delete, which deletes a node. Here are the running times for various operations. You'll notice that Fibonacci heaps are advantageous for insert, union, and decrease key. I'll give you a second to review this table. Please pause the video if you need more time. Fibonacci heaps are used when the number of extract min and delete operations is small. If you rewind back to our chart, in these instances, the runtime is similar to binary heaps. Fibonacci heaps are useful for minimum spanning trees and single source shortest path algorithms such as Dijkstra's. Although in the description, I linked a Stack Overflow article that explores runtime comparisons of binary and Fibonacci heaps. Because they are more complex to implement, Fibonacci heaps are not used all that often in practice. Because of this, I'm not going to go super deep, such as proving runtimes. We may also skip certain methods, such as decrease key and delete. I believe a high-level understanding of Fibonacci heaps is sufficient. Let's take a look at the structure of Fibonacci heaps. A Fibonacci heap is a collection of min heap ordered trees. Here we have four min heap ordered trees. Remember from my heap video that the min heap property means that the key of a node is greater than or equal to that of its parent. For example, if we look at node 31, its key is greater than or equal to the key of its parent, 12. You'll also notice a Fibonacci heap isn't binary in nature. The number of children can vary. In our example, some nodes have 0 children, while node 2 has 3. Let's walk through the attributes of Fibonacci heaps. We maintain several pointers for each node. I'm going to remove the current lines as we color these in. A node has a pointer to its parent, and a node has a pointer to any one of its children. Notice this is any one of them, not all of them. Siblings are linked together by a circular, doubly linked list. If a node is an only child, the left and right pointers point to itself. Because we use circular, doubly linked lists, we can add nodes to a list and concatenate two lists in constant time. Children may appear in any order. If you look at these three nodes, you'll notice there is no specific ordering. We're also going to keep track of the root of our trees in another circular, doubly linked list called the root list, shown in blue. We'll keep a pointer to the minimum node which is the smallest root in the root list. We'll also keep track of n, which is the total nodes in the Fibonacci heap. Lastly, we'll keep track of two other values for each node. First, there is degree, which is the number of children in the node's child list. If we look at node 2, it has a degree of 3, since it has 3 children in its child list. Finally, there is another Boolean attribute called marked that indicates whether the node has lost a child since the last time it was made the child of another node. If that doesn't make sense right now, don't worry. We're going to ignore this until we talk about the degrees key operation, which I may or may not cover in depth. Here's what all that looks like in code. On the left, when we initialize a Fibonacci heap, we keep track of the total number of nodes, a pointer to the minimum node, and a pointer to the root list. On the right, for each individual node, we store its key, degree, and mark, and 4 pointers, one to the parent, child list, and left and right siblings. That wraps up this video. In the next one, we'll walk through examples of the various mergeable heap operations. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.